Pals, it really is swell getting a chance to be here at the Hollywood Canteen, meet you all in person, and say howdy to you. This is Trigger's way of saying hello. Trigger seems to like the ladies in here. How about throwing them a kiss, Trigger? Would you give me a kiss? How about me? Oh, just one? Just give me one kiss. Come on. Doggone, he sure kisses juicy.
Hey everybody, Caleb here in the Rosa String Works Workshop. Today we've got this little Roy Rogers harmony guitar. It's actually in pretty good shape for a 57. But, you know, it's got a couple of things we're going to try to get at. One of the things I've already been doing is kind of scraping off some of the glue on the inside that was squeezed out. They did a pretty sloppy job of gluing this together. But the first big thing we're going to do here is we're going to try to get the neck out. It's loose to some degree, and it needs a neck reset. So that's going to be the first thing we're going to try to do here. I've already noticed the fretboard extension is broken along this fret where it joins the body. You can see where it's broken off, so it shouldn't be too difficult to get off. But I'm going to need to get my tools warming up to, you know, cleanly pull this off and eventually get the neck out of here. So that's what we're going to do first. Well, I've got the heat tool here warming up. It's not quite as warm as we usually get it yet, but I'm going to put it on there. Start getting everything warm. Actually, what I should probably do first is pull that fret where it joins the body, where the fretboard extension is already broken. Now you can see where it was broken. And that very helpful part is we almost don't have the neck joint. I'll see what I can do about that. So Jerry bought this, I think it's actually a styrofoam cutter for removing necks without any water. I measured it with calipers and it came up with 5/64, so I went the next drill bit I have bigger just so that there'd be a little bit of room in that hole. And if this doesn't work like we intend it will, I can still use those little holes to put the steam into. We can do it that way. Right now I'm going to try it like this. I've got two holes on each side of the dovetail. I worry about how fragile the heat stick is, so I'm trying to keep a good handle on it. Make sure it's not bending too much. This is the biggest hurdle when it comes to resetting necks, really, is, you know, we never know how hard these are going to be to get out. They could be, you know, could come real simple, could be real quick. Or they can be such a pain it takes a long time to get the neck to come out. One of the reasons it's hard to tell people what it's going to cost. I'm not exactly sure where I'm going to set this when I take it out. Because I'd like to set it somewhere so I can test and see how loose the neck is. I think we're going to need to put some water in here. That's just not as loose as I would have liked it to have been. I've now got the regular steamer set up. You can see over here I got the kettle full of water in it. Well, not full of water, but it's got some water in it. And it's pushing steam, really warm water. The way the heater, the kind of stove works, is it heats up and then it turns off and it heats up and it turns off. So it doesn't really keep a temperature very well. So the water comes and goes. It doesn't, you know, stay on very well. So this takes a little while to get done. But it's going, and eventually, the nice thing about this is I can pretty much just leave it in there and try and move the neck while it's in there. I can see it starting to move. It's definitely giving some more. So I may need to go get the neck removal jig and get it on here. That may be what helped us get that last bit.
Just making sure it's not getting wet on the inside, and it's not.
So you're not leaking out of the block. I think I'm gonna go get the neck removal jig and hook it up in here and see if that's gonna help me out any. So I've still got the steam going, but I started giving these a couple of cranks, and you can probably see the dovetails coming out. I'm not having to crank this too hard, so it's not really fighting me, and I think it's probably out at this point. But it might just be easier to take it kind of slow. I think we got it. Go ahead and turn the heat off. So there it is, all the way out, and it is wet and a mess. So I'm gonna let everything dry out. While it's still wet, I'll probably get some of this glue off of here. Well, it comes off easy. But we'll give it some time to totally dry before we go doing much else with it. So that's what we'll do. Well, you can see now that the neck's out, this crack that was underneath the fingerboard extension is really showing up. You know, I saw it before, but once the extension was off, you could really see the extent of that crack. And I think part of the reason that crack was there was that brace that runs right there was really loose. Loose to the point in which it just kind of came out when I was feeling in there. So we'll have to put that back in. But the first thing I think we're going to do is try to get this crack closed up. It's looking pretty close. I think that's as close as I'm going to get it. So I'm going to try to get some glue in there and get this all clamped up. I'm going to use this clamp here that pulls the sides of the crack together. Hopefully that'll keep that pulled together and keep glue in there, and should help keep it together when it dries. I'll clamp this into here. I'll have to put some leather on top. There's already some on the bottom. I'll tighten these two down, and then I can turn this, and that will pull it together. So it'll squeeze it tight. Once I get the glue in there, keep it tight so it has time to dry. That way I'm not trying to push the whole thing from the outside. I'm just pulling the crack together. Should work a little bit better. Now this goes all the way through, and it's actually lifted on this side, so I'll have to clamp this down to the neck block to make sure it all stays where I want it to. But that's the idea.
Tonight I'm making my body shaking. Tonight karma's coming back. Tonight there'll be no room for tears in my bedroom. Tonight karma's coming back home. Tonight as I stand here I've noted.
Well, I just pulled this out of the clamp. It set up, a couple of hours at least. Started first thing this morning, and it's after lunch now. So we should be good there. It's looking good. I think the next thing to do is get this brace back in there. However it is I'm going to go about doing that. Yes, there's still some glue stuck on the bottom, so I'm going to try to clean that off. I want to get this totally clean. That way the tight bond will hold it a little bit better. It's most important to just get this surface clean. And I'm not exactly sure how clean the inside is. I'll have to see if I can clean it up some more. Well, maybe I'll try some sandpaper, see how that goes. Well, I'll go ahead and get this cleaned up the rest of the way, and I'll try to bring it back before I glue it in. Alright, so I think I'm ready to glue this in here. I got it pretty clean. It's looking pretty good. It's going to be a little bit of a hassle getting it in there with glue on it. I've got some clamps here ready. And these ones fit right in where they need to, pretty much. I may want to get something with a longer reach, but these will at least get me in there and sitting where it needs to. So I guess here we go.
I'm not really going to be able to get any glue on the inside, although I did clean it up a little bit, the inside of the top. All right, now comes the fun part.
My hands here are trembling as never before. My feelings, I can't hide, resistance is all that.
I've got it clamped in there with one C-clamp. Now I'm going to make sure it's where I want it. It's straight. Well, you can see there, that's all clamped up. So I'm going to give that some good time to dry. Make sure that everything's good. Should be good probably by tomorrow. Well, I just pulled this out of the clamps. Well, I just pulled the clamps off of this. And it's looking good. I'm real happy with the way that brace is attached. It's feeling very solid. And this crank no longer flexes. Imagine that. So I think we're in real good shape with this thing so far. One thing I did off camera was this tail pin. I went ahead and I dyed it black again, the whole thing, and it's looking real good. I think what we're ready to do is start working on the neck. I'm gonna go through and make sure this is all cleaned out, because it's still a little, got a little bit of glue in there. So, do that with it, with my little file. I'll get one of those picks, pick some glue out of there, maybe some sandpaper, maybe a better scraping tool. I just want to make sure this is totally clean, and the other side as well. So I'll do the neck side next. But I think that's the next thing we're going to work on, is the neck. So to check the angle on the neck here on this little Roy Rogers, what I've done is basically set it up to check what the string height will be. So you can see I've got our little 18,000ths pick sitting on the first fret, which if it's set up right, eventually the strings will hold that pick down, so they would be sitting on top of that pick, and then they'd also be sitting on top of the saddle. So if I put the straight edge down, that is acting as my string height for the angle this neck is set at. Because the body joins at the 12th fret and I've pulled that 12th fret, I need something to shim up my gauge to the height of the frets, and this little piece of wood I had laying around is pretty much the same height as the frets. So I just put it in here and then I can run my gauge in, and it would be just like checking the string height once the neck was glued in. And I run into the straight edge at about 94,000ths, which is pretty good. It's definitely a lot better than it was. So I'm actually pretty happy with where this neck is as of right now. The big question is whether I can get it out, put glue in it, on the dovetail and all around it, get it back in, and hope that it's in the same location. I think I should be able to move this to one side, clamp it in the center, and then check it all again. I should be able to do that. I don't see any reason why I couldn't. And that way, once it's glued up, I can check to make sure it's still right. I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get ready to have this clamped up. It holds that location. It's not like there's a lot of weight sitting on it, stressing the neck in any way. It's pretty much just where it sits. I just gotta get it out, get glue on it, I guess. So I'm gonna go get a clamp ready, figure out how I'm gonna do that, because that's kind of a little surface area I wanna hit on right there. At least to start off with. I guess I can come back and do the whole thing. Maybe put a block in. That would make sense. I might try that. But at first I want to just clamp onto the dovetail, not onto the fingerboard, so that I can check the height. So I'm gonna get prepped to do that.
Pride will rush outside the moment she walks through the door. The lips that have kissed her, that's loved her and missed her, or lips that have cursed her at night. In anguish and torment, I've cursed as the nights went from darkness till dawn's golden light. I thought of just taking these two hands and breaking that body I'm aching to touch. I find while I'm waiting, there's there's no time for hating while anticipating the wall.
So, I'm getting ready to glue on this fretboard extension here, and I've got these two kind of side rails clamped on here so this fretboard extension can't move side to side, so that it will stay lined up with the fretboard. Actually, this is try number two on gluing this fretboard extension down, because the first one moved. So that's why I'm taking a little bit of an extra precaution here, and I'm just making sure it's lined up right. It seems like it's just a little bit further this way, which means I bump it, I think. Well, that was too much. That seems good there. So hopefully these will help me keep it aligned while I put the clamps on it. Then I'll take these off so that the glue doesn't stick them to anything or anything we don't want. But I'm going to leave it on there just to get the glue on it. But I think we're ready to do that. I've got all my clamps sitting over here. I just need to make sure I have enough full leather for everything. I want it so much. You can see the fretboard extension glued up real nice, lines up real good, and I've actually got that 12th fret back in there. So we're ready to move on. The next thing I'm going to do is do a real light fret leveling just to make sure there's no high frets. Then we'll crown them and repolish them. Worry about this fret right here. It seems just a little high. That's kind of where the fretboard extension changes direction, is right in there, where it should start its downward slope. Alright, that's looking pretty good. So now I'll get the crowning tool, put through here and recrown all these.
Nervous, I'm trembling, recalling, remembering the way that she tosses her head. I've given much thought to the fact that I ought to have more control over my life.
Alright, so now that they're all crowned, I'm going to take some sandpaper, and I've got this piece of 400 that's been fairly well used. I'm going to start with it, just making sure I'm knocking those file marks off of those frets. Alright, so then I'll move to 600, and 1200. After the 1200, I am going to get one of the fret guards. I'm not sure how well it's going to work down here. It'll work. And some semi-chrome. And I'm going to use the semi-chrome to polish them, each of the frets. This really makes them look brand new. And just a little dab of the semi-chrome will get quite a few of the frets done. And then the one thing I forgot is that the saddle on this guitar is made out of the same stuff all the frets are. So I'm going to take the 1200 and do the saddle. Nice and shiny frets. I'm going to do the saddle just to do it. It's got a couple little marks in it. I think the 1200 will help. I'll show you those frets now. They were dull before and now they're very reflective, so it should feel really good to play on. I think we're ready to start setting this thing up. Well, I said I was going to set this up with strings next, but I changed my mind. I'm going to put a little bit of white paint on here. I think the customer really wanted us to touch this up as much as we could. And I think it's just going to be easier to do before the strings are on it. In this case, at least. I've already gone through with some of the dark brown dye and done a lot of little spots on the darker spots. You know, touch them up where they'd lost the paint color. So now I'm going through and I've got a little bit of white paint here on a tiny, tiny paintbrush. I'm going to touch up all the white spots. So I think you can see what I'm doing here. This is going to take me a little bit. But I do think it's really going to help the look when I get all the way around and it's solid white again rather than where it's worn off, especially on the edges. There is just a tiny, tiny, tiny amount of yellow in this white paint in my little cup here. It's helping me get the aged look. I really do think, though, this is going to be one of those things that, you know, as time-consuming as it is really going to help the look of this instrument. I guess I've shown enough of me painting, so I'll turn the camera off and bring you back when I'm doing something a little more interesting. I think that was a big improvement, getting all that paint on there. It's not dry yet, but I definitely think all the little touch-ups, especially around the edges where it had just worn off, really improves the look of that top. And there's still a couple of spots I just noticed over here. Right here I'm going to try to hit again. I'm going to have to give this some time to dry before I put any strings on it. I thought you might want to see it since I just got it finished. Give it some good time to dry and then we can start setting this thing up. Well, you can see we got some strings on here now, and they're not tuned up to pitch yet, but I've been working on getting it to where we can do that. The first thing I did was I filed some height off the top of that nut. The slots were really deep in it, but there was a lot of height, so I went ahead and shaved that down with the files. It's looking pretty good. The other thing I did was I tried to clean up the top and the back a little bit. I just used the semi-chrome polish to do it, and really I just kind of buffed it out. It's not real shiny, but it's not real meant to be shiny, so it looks pretty good. It's definitely cleaned up from how it was. There was lots of just little bits of gunk kind of stuck on or wiped on here that just knocked off. So I think we're ready to tune this up to pitch. The other thing I did was I oiled all the tuners. Hopefully get them working a little better. Go ahead and hold this and just pick tune it. On these really small guitars, you really want to go with light gauge strings. They're just not set up structurally to deal with regular strings. Usually that is, especially with the older ones. See what we got here. Sorry. Well, if you remember, on the back of this little Roy Rogers, the paint was kind of wearing off around the edges, just like it was on the front with the white. And I thought it would look a little better if I could get some brown paint and just touch that up. So I asked Jerry if we had any brown paint, and after looking around, we didn't have any brown paint. But we did have red and green and black paint, and so now we have my best approximation of brown paint. So I mixed up, you know, the red and the green and a little bit of the black and got pretty close. I've already touched up a lot of this. I noticed there's just a little spot back here I wanted to hit in. And there's some spots on the headstock I haven't touched yet. Well, after our couple of brown paint touch-ups, this little Roy Rogers is looking a lot better. I think they really help make it look not so old and worn, especially around those edges where all the paint had come off. I'll give you a good look at the whole thing again, because it's done. Just a little bit of dust in, and we'll stick it in its case, and it can be on its way. So I'll play it for you a little bit so you can hear how it sounds. It's definitely a more novelty instrument than it is for, you know, real professional music making. With the shorter scale, you can pull those strings out of tune real easy. So you gotta be careful when you're fretting it. But, you know, it's fairly nice for what it is. We got the action real low with that neck reset, so it feels real good to play. And I found that if you play right here, you can get a pretty good sound out of it. Well, I think that's it for this Roy Rogers. I hope you enjoyed watching this one. If you did, a thumbs up would be much appreciated. And if you haven't already, subscribing would be the most appreciated. Thanks for watching.
Sunny.